number two, Eric Brackett is there. Ryan Timmons there. Tommy Gaither there. Cody Stillwell looking for Tom Reisch. Where are you, Tom? Hi, yellow light off. We'll just go without the 57. Here we go. Eight laps for the B-Mods. Tim Hancock, Eric Brackett. Tim Hancock, Eric Brackett, Ryan Timmons. 14, Tommy Gaither. Zero, Tim Hancock leads the way. Being chased by Eric Brackett. Hornet Heats are up next. B-Mods being led by Zero, Tim Hancock. And Eric Brackett at two. 14, Tommy Gaither. Double zero, Cody Stillwell. And 23, Ryan Timmons. Two laps to go for Tim Hancock. Two laps to go. One more lap to go. White flag for Tim Hancock. All right, here comes the checkered flag for Zero, Tim Hancock. Gaither, Stillwell, and Brackett follow up. And the Zero car, Tim Hancock, picks up another B-Mod heat. He is leading the UMP National point standings for the B-Mods. It's the Country Girls Salon in Mount Olive. Walsh Concrete of Caseyville. Zero, Tim Hancock goes through the scales. Weight is legal. He is over 2,400 pounds and carrying a checkered flag. Zero, Tim Hancock.
Or Shannon Babb's really big fans of both of them. I'm not sure really how it worked, but they're all 18 and that's all that really matters. And now the green flag is coming out and we're gonna go. Travis Hendrickson making popcorn on the back stretch. He is into the infield at 18. Jerry Thompson starting to run away with heat race number two. Car number one, Jacob Franklin. Third place car, 55, Tim Reisch. Rounding out the order, Steve Phillips in second place, all chasing down Jerry Thompson from Troy, down south off Interstate 55. He is four laps up and four laps to go. Lap to go for Jerry Thompson. He's coming out of that third and fourth turn. Steve Phillips in second place. The race for third place, Timmy Reisch. Going alongside Jacob Franklin. That important race for third. Going to finish with Jacob Franklin in front of Tim Reisch. Completing B BMOD Heat Race number 2 comes to a finish, and we're ready now for the Hornet Heats. These heats will have no bearing on the Hornet makeup feature from last week. The Hornet Challenge, the 1,000 to win race, these will just be a regular heat race to set up the lineup for the regular feature for tonight at the end of the program. And there's Jerry Thompson from Troy with a checkered flag in his hand. And the Chevy chassis, car number 18. We're set to go for cylinder racing.
All right, yellow light is off. Ready to go with first heat for the Hornets. And here we go. Rolling, rolling. 9-11. 33, car number 1. See a 1R. Says Tony Reed on it. We got Brad Rectrode, Jeremy Reed, Tony Reed, and the 21 of Joe McChristie. Brad Rectrode trying to stay ahead of Jeremy Reed, and Jerry's coming after him. Brad Rectrode. Two laps to go for Brad Rectrode. Jeremy Reed's working, trying to get him. He's right to his bumper, coming for the white flag. Brad Rectrode's got to hold off Jeremy Reed for one more lap. They're side by side, and the yellow. Yellow for 25, Caleb Branch. Cone,
and the green light comes on, they can start racing.
And here they go. 33, Jeremy Reed. Here comes Tony Reed on the one car. Looking like taking second away. One more lap to go for Jeremy Reed. Brad Rectrode, Tony Reed, throwing out a lot of smoke out of that car number 1. As 33, Jeremy Reed gets a checkered flag. And car number 111, Brad Rectrode. And 1R Tony Reed in third place. 33, Jeremy Reed will get the checkered flag. Well, who do we have taking pictures tonight? I think I saw Double J a minute ago. And up top on the photo stand, there's Bud Boss Video doing the videos. Jeremy Reed rides with a checkered flag.
Thought they should see the green flag next time around. Nope, next time by they'll see the green. Next week it's Casey General Store night here at Macon Speedway. A slice of summer giveaway is at Casey's General Store. Green flag comes out, green light comes on. And Austin Wickline and Michael Gossett out in front of Adam Webb will be able to stay that way for 6 whole laps. Let's see. Michael Gossett, G3, currently leading in front of Adam Webb as they come across to lap number 2. Austin Wickline sticking in third place in front of 87. That is Ryan Cantrell. Side by side. Look at the great side by side racing in the corner. Adam Webb's going to beat Michael Gossett out of the fourth turn. Here comes the big white flag. A lap to go here. Adam Webb looking to join Jeremy Reed as heat winners. Still another heat race to go before we get to the street stocks. Checkered flag out of the fourth turn. Here he comes. Adam Webb from Decatur with a victory. Former National Hornet champion. Track champion here at Macon gets the win in front of Michael Gossett and Austin Wickline. 87 Ryan Cantrell finishes in fourth. There's heat number two in the books. And Adam Webb, track champion, National Hornet champion with a victory here at Macon.
Victory photo, and we have a green flag. Here we go. And here comes a 20 car of Torrey Lyons. Torrey Lyons leads the way. Jared Matherly on the outside. Jared Matherly takes over the lead as they come off turn four. Jared Matherly, Torrey Lyons, Cook Crawford, Brian Offer. Okay. Coming around to get the green flag waved at him, but two laps to go. Jared Matherly in J4. Torrey Lyons, Cook Crawford, and Brian Offer. Here comes Jared Matherly to get the white flag and one lap to go. Jared Matherly, Torrey Lyons, Cook Crawford, Brian Offer, and the 121 Jared Hemingway. Checkered flag is in the air for Jared Matherly in J4, followed by Torrey Lyons and Cook Crawford. J4, Jared Matherly gets the heat win. All right, here comes Jared Matherly pick up his checkered flag. Nelson's Termite and Pest Control on the side of that J4. Street stocks are on the way. Modifieds get ready to go. And here's Jared Matherly. Give Jared a wave and a yell.
That's a ticket. Will be set to go green this time around. Eight laps. Again, the top five cars are automatically into the feature race in the Big Ten Street Stock Series race. Here they come. Let's go green. Jeff Reed Jr. comes out on top out of the second turn. Looking to dash away from Jordan Smith and Dave Crawley Jr. Dave Crawley Jr. contesting Jeff Reed Jr.'s top spot, and he's going to take it away from him here in the third lap. Yellow flag comes out as Charles Wiesenthal from Athens is facing the wrong way on the back stretch side, Crawley bringing Jr. up the yellow, leading the way over Jeff Reed Jr. And the green flag comes out. Here they go again. Keep a watchful eye on J24. Jeremy Nichols started in the back. He's worked his way up to fourth so far. He's going to glide on the bottom and see if he can make a little bit of movement. Jordan Smith, Jeff Reed Jr. not giving up their spot easily, but they are indeed giving it up. Nick Justice also getting in there. Oh, collision on turn two. Jordan Walton. Jamie Sudarth, he is in the number five spot to advance on to the feature. Yellow was for the yellow car, Jeff Reed Jr. He is in the back, gonna have to try to work his way forward. As Dave Crawley Jr. and Jeremy Nichols battle for the top spot. Race for third place, Jordan Smith, Nick Justice. White flag is in the air. Checkered flag on the way, Dave Crawley Jr., Jeremy Nichols, Jordan Smith, and Nick Justice finish third and fourth, and then fifth place goes to Jeffrey Jr. They will go into the feature. Jamie Sutter, Charles Biesenthal will make their way into the semi-feature. Jordan Smith is the third place finisher in front of 36 Nick Justice. And we'll get ready to go with our second street stock heat race. Again, top five of those cars will move on to the main show. On to the scales comes Dave Crawley Jr. in the 22 car.
Greg Osmond jumped up and changed numbers. Eight laps for street stock heat number two. Here we go. Greg Osmond takes off. Caleb Wood moves up. 86 just trying to get out of the way. James Bowen. Watch out, Terry Reed trying to work through the traffic. He can't get through it. They're three wide in front of him. Got nowhere to go. Hang on, seven. Kevin Lewis, the three car. 3T Kevin Lewis. There's Greg Osmond, Caleb Wood. 16 Nick Macklin. 08 Brian Dotsenbrock. Terry Reed having a rough time breaking through the traffic. Just now starting to move. The 86 found the wall. Greg Osmond, Caleb Wood, Nick Macklin, Brian Dotsenbrock, Terry Reed. Two laps to go. Brian Dotsenbrock, Caleb Woods working him over. And now Nick Macklin working on second place. Caleb Wood with one lap to go. Greg Osmond, Caleb Wood, Nick Macklin, Brian Dotsenbrock, and Terry Reed. Checkered flag is in the air. Look at him. Almost bumper to bumper. Here comes the 28 car, Greg Osmond. Greg Osmond picks up the win in heat number one. Wow, Greg Osmond, Caleb Wood, Nick Macklin. And behind them, the battle was warming up as we ran out of laps with Terry Reed and Brian Dotsenbrock. Greg Osmond, Waits Dry Cleaners, Diamonds Family Restaurant, car number 28, picks up the heat win. Billingsley Towing Modifieds get ready to go. And here comes Greg Osmond with a checkered flag. Next Saturday night, Casey's General Stores and Armed Forces Night.
Here we go, green flags are coming. Everybody grouped together, ready to get the jump on it, and there they go. Luke Force from Argenta. Rudy Zaragoza, 67. He's from Jacksonville. That's a long trip to get here. Oh, look out as they're bunched up over in the front stretch. Jeremiah Hobley is stuck on to by 21R Dustin Reed. Birthday to Aiden. Celebrate with some ice cream. Green flag is out. There they go. Luke Force getting a good jump. Rudy Zaragoza slowed all the way down, having all kinds of trouble in there. Lost himself all the way back to fifth. Kyle Waters up to second place. Justin Lane, Jeremiah Hoadley, then Rudy Zaragoza sticking out in front of Garrett Lewis for that final transfer spot into the main event. John Bright Jr. closing the gap here in the red number seven. The race for first is on. Look at Luke Force holding on, but only by inches, as Kyle Waters is making a move on the bottom of the speedway with two laps to go. Kyle Waters takes the lead on the lap. To the bottom this time goes Luke Force. Can he take the lead away? Checkered flag on the way. Here he comes, 26 Kyle Waters from Oriana. Heat winner with Luke Force, Justin Lane. Jeremiah Hobley finishes fourth. Fifth place on his way to the main event, 67 Rudy Zaragoza. Dustin Reed, John Bright Jr. on their way to the semi feature. Kyle Waters started third row inside. Street stocks now complete, getting ready to go for the Billingsley Towing Modifieds. Don't forget, coming up, intermission spectator races. We're bringing them back. If you want to participate in that, talk to somebody at the front gate. Be more than happy to get you your very own car sitting out there in the parking lot. You can bring it out here onto the Macon Speedway, race one lap. Just like Kyle Waters just did, you might be able to get the checkered flag
challenge
in your hand.
Feature that was rained out last week will follow the late model heat races. All right, T.D. Berger bringing them to the green. Billingsley Towing Modified. There we go. And Rodney Snederber had a little trouble getting away. And the yellow comes out.
Try again.
Here we go. Rodney Snederber pushes just a little bit ahead of T.D. Berger. And leads lap number one. Per Rhodes goes to second. Kerr Rhodes trying to give Rodney Snederber a challenge for the lead. Rodney Snederber, Kerr Rhodes, T.D. Berger, and Blake Thompson in seventh. Kurt tries the outside. Two laps to go. Perot going to the inside. Rodney's holding him off. Barely, but he's holding him. One more lap to go. Rodney Snederber, Perot, T.D. Berger, Blake Thompson. Like Rodney's got it under control. Now here comes 28, Rodney Snederber.
Rodney Stadiver gets the win. And Rodney Stadiver takes the win for the Billingsley Towing Modified. He won. All right, heat number two is on the track. Go ahead.
Green flag out, and there they go with our second heat for the Billingsley Towing Modifieds. Out to the lead, Brian Lynn, a Lincoln Speedway track champion through the years. Out to a good quick start here in lap number one. Dave Crawley Jr. sticking to the bottom. Kelikovsky giving him fits in the race for third place. Kelikovsky giving himself fits now as he falls to the tail. Dave Crawley Jr. bouncing up to the second place spot in front of 14C Alan Crowder. Four laps up, Brian Lynn still out on top. Out, Sean Vaughn flies into the infield out of the second turn. Green flag is out as the yellow flag comes around. Should have a nice three-lap finish here. Dave Crawley Jr. can stick onto the bumper of Brian Lynn. Here they come, one lap to go this time. Glued to the bottom of the racetrack. Here comes Brian Lynn. Up top this time goes Dave Crawley Jr. It'll be a win for Brian Lynn. Alan Crowder, Jeff Graham, Kelikovsky, and Sean Vaughn finish up the field. Dave is going to try something different that time as he went up top. And 72 from Mason City, Brian Lynn, with the checkered flag coming his way as he makes his way onto the scales, and the pro late models are set to go with their heat races. Their lineups were put together by the way they completed their single car qualifying earlier in the show. Checkered flag in his hand, Brian Lynn in 72.
Overland. Here we go. Joey Webb's ready with the green flag and the green light. Matt Taylor and Robin Huffman up on the front row, and here we go! Robin Huffman leads lap number one. Huffman, Matt Taylor, Dakota Ewing, and Alan Crowder. And now Matt Taylor putting a challenge to Robin Huffman. 1-2, bumper to bumper. Watch Matt Taylor now as he challenges Robin Huffman for the win. Coming through turns three and four. Here comes Robin Huffman, followed by Matt Taylor. Robin Huffman picks up the win. Quite a challenge there by Matt Taylor. But Robin hangs on to it. Harold and Robin Huffman Garage of Midland City. Good guys, snow removal. Could almost use them tonight. 33H Robin Huffman with a checkered flag. As heat number two rolls onto the racetrack.
Again, the 24, Jeremy Nichols, just taking a lap here at the tail end. He's not a part of this race in any way, racing the street stock. Just making sure the car is in fine working order. Might have tweaked on something earlier on. All right, here we go. Green flag for the Pro Late Models. J38J, Jake Little, 6P Jose Parga. Bring him around to the first lap. Watchful eye on the red 4T, Guy Taylor. He knows how to win races here, making Speedway a track champion in both the modifieds and the pro lates through the years. John Ziemer, Eric Wilson having a nice battle for fourth place, sticking side by side with one another. Two laps to go for 38J, Jake Little. Jose Parga. Still out in front of Guy Taylor. Checkered flag hits the air. And it's Jake Little's race to win in front of Jose Parga. Guy Taylor finishing third. Fourth place, Eric Wilson. Sean Ziemer fifth. And 75, Shane Pyatt. A win for Jake Little in the Pro Late Model division. Finishes up our heat races. And now will come our Hornet Challenge makeup feature. That'll be followed by the Street Stocks semi-feature race. Street Stocks semi, head to the gate. You're coming up next. There's Jake Little. Pleasant Plains, Illinois, on a weekend. Street Stocks semi again. You're up next. You are following these 25 laps. They're all going to bunch together. Have you got your favorite Hornet picked? Who's going to win it? 25 laps to go. Here come the Hornets. Let's go. Four-cylinder front-wheel drive cars going through the front stretch onto the back straightaway now. Take a look as they come on through. It is 40, Adam Webb, 33, Jeremy Reed, 04, Troy Newberry, and J4, Jared Matherly. Right now, the top four cars. Lost the wheel on the back stretch. 39M Marty Sullivan. The car has lost the right or the left front wheel. And the yellow flag is out on lap number three. Thing is coming. 22 laps to go. Catching up to the lap traffic now come the lead pack as they make their way around. See if that'll open up some room. Brad Rextrode trying to take fourth place away from J4. Jared Matherly slows down with a lap car in the way. Might be the room that the 911 needs to take third place away. Adam Webb, Jeremy Reed crossing the front line with lap number 9 complete. 04, Troy Newberry in front of J4, Jared Matherly, 911, Brad Rextrode, the top 5 as they go through the 3rd and 4th turns. Top 2 cars are in the 2nd turn. We are halfway through the Hornet Challenge. Adam Webb in front of Jeremy Reed by a car length or two. And Jeremy Reed into the infield. Looks like smoke pouring out of the engine of the 33. He's gonna park it. And Adam Webb, way out in front, looks to sweep the Hornet Challenge. Cars bunching up into the third and fourth turns. 04 Troy Newberry, he's now the second place car. Brad Rextrode, Jared Matherly, 3 and 4. J4, Jared Matherly, Ashley Gatens, oh, Troy Newberry! Bumped in to the back end of the 4A Ashley Gatens. Went sliding in. J4, Jared Matherly, they were each battling for the second, third, and fourth spot with the 04. And now, them possibly popping a radiator, here comes some liquid out on the racetrack. They'll get a little shovel time on the front straightaway. 20 out of the 25 laps down here in this Hornet Challenge 1,000 to win feature. Here goes a green flag on the way. Adam Webb out in front. Tony Reed, Brad Rextrode, Jared Matherly, Michael Gossett. They are the cars in the top 5 spots. White flag in the air. Adam Webb, a lap away from sweeping the Hornet Challenge. Got this position from winning a dash last week. This week, completing the Hornet Challenge, it's Adam Webb. Wins the Hornet Challenge feature race. Wins the $1,000. One R, Tony Reed in the second place finish. 9-11, Brad Rextrode. J4, Jared Matherly, all finishing behind. Car number 40, Adam Decatur. Give him a big hand. Give him a big old wave.
Adam Webb comes to victory lane. Give Adam a chance to get out of that race car. Get congratulated by the other drivers participating in the race. All right, here comes Adam Webb out of the race car. Took a couple weeks, but you completed the sweep.
Oh yeah, man, that's tough against these guys, Tony, Jeremy, all these guys that race out here week to week with us. Man, it feels good. I'm glad I won it for Jim and Barbie and my wife and my kids and all the sponsors.
I get the sponsors. You get the big trophy. And Double J, go get your picture. Got Cheap Ass Auto Repair. We don't want to forget about them. Got Studio 505, Canning and Salon in Clinton. Good Deal Auto Sales in Clinton and Lincoln. AJ Motorsports. And there we have our victory photo. Adam Webb in victory lane with the Hornet Challenge sweep of the 11 that we're supposed to run. That's not a bad bunch. Top five will go into the feature. I think it says 10 laps for this one. Here we go. Charles Wiesenthal didn't get away very well. John Bright's moving. There goes Jason Scripture and Jamie Sutter. The 21 of Justin Reed. Here comes four, Matt Rita. We've got 86 over in turn three. James Bowen spins it in turn three to bring out the yellow. And he is back underway. 14, Charles Wiesenthal. 3T, Kevin Lewis. 7, John Bright Jr. 28, Garrett Lewis. 86, James Bowen. And here we go, and there goes a wheel from Jamie Sutter's car. Lost, I believe, the right rear came off. Well, we go weeks and weeks and weeks without losing any wheels, and tonight we've gotten two
Wing
now.
Sprints,
Midwest Tech Modifieds, Power Eye Illini Division II Midgets, and Pro Late Models Friday night at Lincoln Speedway. Well, the hoods come up. Matt Reed's car number 4, you see the hood? He's having a hard time seeing what's going on in front of him. The hood on the 4 car. But Jason Scripture's running away. Matt Reed's not doing too bad a job for having an obstacle in his view. Jason Scripture, 21 Dustin Reed, 14 Charles Wiesenthal, 3T Kevin Lewis, 4 Matt Reed, 7 John Bright Jr., 86 James Bowen. Here's Jason Scripture, 55, leading the field. Unofficially right now with
John Blythe Jr. in fifth place. He looks like he might make the feature. Jason Scripture coming around looking for the white flag. One to go for Jason Scripture. 21 Dustin Reed. 14 Charles Wiesenthal. 3T Kevin Lewis. 7 John Blythe Jr. There's a checkered flag for 55. Jason Scripture going to the feature. All righty then, Jason Scripture gets the street stock semi feature. And moving on with a checkered flag, Jason Scripture, I'll give him a hand when he comes by. He's ready to go feature racing. All right, here comes Jason Scripture with a checkered flag.
All right, Beamon featured in the gate.
We're going to let the Buick now start on the inside lane. I don't think he's going to beat the S10, but the S10 had the better starting position that time. So we'll bring him around with a white car, the Buick of Justin Binkley on the inside. And on the outside, we're going to have Randy Tomlinson. We need B-Mods to the gate. B-Mod, feature to the gate. B-Mod, feature to the gate. Here we go. Do you think the white car will win now? What do you think about Binkley and the Buick? All right, not a lot of fans. What do you think about the S10? I think the fans think the S10 is going to win. Joey Webb, wave him the green. We are ready for the second race in our spectator drags. Go for it. Green is out. Oh, the Buick had the better start. S10's got his work cut out for him. Can Tomlinson do it? Look at him take it into the corner. Up the track he goes, wheeling it sideways a little bit. Going to come off. Oh, the Buick dives are in deep. Oh, he hit too much brake. Brake only slows you down here. Checkered flag. And the S10. Randy Tomlinson in the Chevy S10 claims the win. Hey, fans, does that look like a little bit of fun to get to do yourself? Remember, later this season, we'll have another one. I want you folks to sign up for us. And we'll give you a chance to race right here at Macon Speedway. So we're going to bring the S10 down. We're gonna send the Buick off. We're gonna bring the S10 down. He's gotta come to victory lane here. We got him a trophy. He's gonna get to celebrate in Macon Speedway victory lane. You hear the B-Mods firing up in the pits. They're getting ready for feature action, a 15 lapper coming up. Randy Tomlinson. Let's give him a nice round of applause. Your winner of Spectator Drags tonight here at Macon Speedway. Get a word with him out here in front of you fans. Randy, good job. Inside lane, you made it look easy. The outside lane was a little tougher.
Yeah, it was.
You put her up on the cushion, kicked her a little sideways, bounced her off the cushion, maybe the wall a little bit, and you were good to go, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Let's give a nice round of applause to the Caters, Randy Tomlinson. B-Mod feature coming up next.
Family would certainly appreciate every single dollar that you could possibly give them. They're had to be in Tennessee tomorrow, so help them out with those gas stops, so much more. Zero, Tim Hancock out to the early lead here in the B-Modified feature race. 15 laps to go. Out in front of car number 14, that is Tommy Gaither. 20 for Steve Phillips, car number 18, Jerry Thompson running in the number 4 spot. Whoop, now the number 5 spot is 00S. Cody Stillwell closing in. Jerry Thompson to the infield now after smacking the wall on the backstretch, and the yellow flag has come out. Yellow lights off. We got 3 laps down out of 15. Tim Hancock on the gas, and there they go. Tim Hancock looking to go 3 for 3 here at Macon Speedway and feature wins in the B-Modified group. Green flag is out, 2 laps to go. It's lap number 13. He's smoking the competition. Boy, he is a good quarter lap ahead of everybody else. Lap to go. Tommy Gaither closest to him, and he's just now entering the fourth turn. Street Stocks, you're up next. Street Stocks head to the gate as Tim Hancock finds victory lane. Tommy Gaither, Steve Phillips will finish second and third. Street Stocks get run into the gate. Your feature's up next. As we finish up the B-Modified feature, Mount Olives. Tim Hancock with a victory. Tips on the scales, got to weigh a certain amount, and he does. Mentioned it earlier, we were talking about that helmets that are being walked around here on the front stretch and the back stretch, looking for some donations, heading down to Tennessee. Bubba has brain cancer in stage 3. He's got to go back there the next few weeks. Tim Hancock, front stretch. He's got the checkered flag in his hand.
Country Girl Salon, St. Louis Dirt Track Racing. Mike's Tractor sponsors on their race car. And he does it again. Leading those national points. They give you a trophy to match your car. Something blue, yeah. You got this track all figured out, don't you?
I hope I do.
Looks like another good night for you. You're leading those national points now.
Yeah, I don't want to get caught up in them, but we probably will, so we'll see how it goes.
It's nice to have, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I've done good in them before, so we'll see how it finishes.
All right, Tim Hancock with another B-Mod feature. Twenty laps for the street stocks. They stay in formation coming to that last tractor tire in the turn four, and the white chalk line, it's the theoretical starting spot. Dave Crawley Jr., Greg Osmond, Kyle Waters, Jeremy Nichols, Caleb Wood, Luke Force, the top three cars ready to go. 20 laps. Yellow lights off. Coming to the fourth turn, green flag, here we go! Dave Crawley Jr. leads the way at 22. Here comes Kyle Waters ahead of Greg Osmond, Jeremy Nichols, Caleb Wood, and Luke Force, Nick Macklin, and the 7-11 of Justin Lane. Greg Osmond up to the wall at turn four.
Crawley
Jr. in the 22 car leads the way. John Bright Jr. comes the infield. Around goes Kevin Lewis. 3T down at turn two. A whole lot of steam coming out of that car. All right, yellow lights off. Picking it up with six laps down as Dave Crawley brings him to the green. Wiesenthal put it up on its nose, and gravity kept him from rolling it over.
Brought him.
I love Jeremy Nichols got problems with that car. He just signaled everybody to go around him.
Reed.
67 Rudy Saragoza. Here we go. Dave Crawley Jr. leads the way, and now Jeff Reed comes to a stop. He spun it over there coming out of turn two. Just didn't get it moving quick enough. As they come off turn four, green flag, here we go! Dave Crawley Jr., 24 Jeremy Nichols, 26 Kyle Waters. And Jeremy Nichols is off the gas. Whatever was wrong with 24, it's finally come out and brings it to the infield. He's been having troubles with that car, even though it's been going pretty fast. And 7-11 Justin Lane and Luke Force. Here comes Dave Crawley Jr., 22. Macklin, 16, on the move, up to second place around Kyle Waters. Going after the 22 of Dave Crawley Jr. And the yellow comes out. Couple of cars get together down in turn one to bring out the yellow. Brian Dotzenbrock's 08, Jeff Reed in 52. And here we go. To go, two to go for Dave Crawley Jr., Nick Macklin, Kyle Waters, Caleb Wood, Justin Lane, and Luke Force. Here comes the white flag, one lap to go. Dave Crawley Jr. looking to pick up a feature win in the 22 car. Here's the checkered flag for Dave Crawley Jr. Nick Macklin, we got a three-way jam right at the very end. Wow! Woo-hoo-hoo! That looked like that was going to be a bigger mess than it turned out to be. Crawley Jr. with a feature win. Billingsley Towing Modifieds are on the way. And here comes Dave Crawley Jr. with a checkered flag. The SQ22. Car X Auto Service, another sponsor on that car. Sharp Electric. And Dave Crawley Jr. comes out of the race car. You make that car look fast.
It's pretty fast. It's for sale. You can have it for $8,500. Jeremy was up there. I seen him on the bottom of me, putting the pressure on me. I was probably overdriving the car. But I'd just like to thank Chad, Anthony, and Sean for letting me drive this in the Big Ten Series and have a little fun. I just can't thank him enough, and all his sponsors. Thanks, Hazel. Thanks, Wheat, for giving me a truck to get here. And I better go race.
All right, trophy time for Dave Crawley Jr. And it's time for the Billingsley Towing Modifieds.
Backstretch, wave them on. Billingsley Towing Modified, set to go green. They're going to wave them on this time around. Front stretch, it's your turn to wave them on. Don't be frozen and glued to your seat. Stand up and give them a wave. They're waving right back at you now, showing their appreciation for you showing up. Give them a big wave. Give them a big holler. We got some really, really good cars in the first two rows of this feature race. Rodney Sandiford, Brian Lind, Kurt Rhodes, and Dave Crawley Jr. Definitely not going to be easy for any of these drivers here tonight. Here, 20 laps to go, and here we go. Sandiford and Lind leading it out on top. There goes Sean Vaughn at 98, facing the wrong way in the third turn. Yellow comes out. Drivers will be encouraged to stick to the north. Rodney Sandiford darn near ran into Sean Vaughn. Rockin' Rodney will lead him around, and here we go. Brian Lind giving Rodney Sander for all he can handle through the first six laps of this one. Kurt Rhodes, oh no, into the infield comes car number 10 as he was running the inside lane with 37 Dave Crawley Jr. into the line and over at turn one, TD Berger and car number 7 Blake Thompson get together, leading to the yellow right behind Brian Lind. Just couldn't seem to get around him, and now through the infield he goes. Out of the car,
Rodney
being checked down.
Sandifer
on the gas, trying to beat Brian Lind and Dave Crawley Jr., as well as now Alan Crowder into the number 4 spot in the order. Bunched up in turn number 3, Sean Vaughn to a stop in car number 7, Blake Thompson. Thompson of Wyoming's Sean Vaughn collide into one another. Thompson drives away, but not Vaughn, who has stopped over in turn 3. Oh, Brian Lind stuck with him pretty good through that fourth turn. Dave Crawley Jr. will test the top side to try to get by Brian Lind as they approach the halfway point of the Billingsley Towing Modified feature race. Three cars closing in on the top spot with six laps to go. Dave Crawley cuts to the bottom. Second place is his in front of Brian Lynn. Now he's got his eyes set on the leader, Rodney Standifer, as they come across. Standifer still on top. He will cut to the bottom. Look out, contact made. Crawley takes the lead. Five laps to go. Crawley, Standifer, Lynn, the top three cars. Jeff Graham slowing down on the front straightaway. He finds the infield. Three laps to go. White flag coming around. Brian Lynn, Rodney Standifer trying to give it one more shot. A fifth of a mile to go for Dave Crawley Jr. as he comes across the backstretch. Street stock feature winner, modified feature winner. Crawley goes back to back and gets the win. Brian Lynn, Rodney Standifer, and Alan Crowder finish in the top four spots. All the three top cars got close together. They all changed positions one through three. From Decatur with a feature win in the Billingsley Towing Modifieds. S&S Auto Sales.
Back. Dave Crawley Jr. Barb's Place, Line A Overhead Doors, Hazel's Hall and S&S Auto Sales. High Side Graphics sponsors on that car. Mud Boss Video. Amazing. You work, boy.
Man, I ain't sitting here trying to complain, but these guys that want to hog the whole dang racetrack, got a top and a bottom groove, wash all the way out, they're going to get their ass hit or moved out of the way because I'm tired of that. But get on the bottom. You want to run the bottom, you want to run the top, get on the top. I did the same thing on the end of that race as they were doing me, but it's just frustrating out there. You tear up your car, but... Thanks, Steve Hazel, Weed, for loaning me a truck to get me here. This all the fans, Jody, Calvin. There's a lot of people, I think. Wingo in turn four came down and helped me out tonight. Thanks, Jacob. Like I said, it's not trying to complain too much. It's just hard to race like that, but we pulled it off.
Well, I'll tell you, that's patience. I mean, you just had to be patient. Patient and keep finding, looking for an opening.
Yeah, it's I hate getting into Kurt. You get a big run, it's hard to hit the brake. I hit the brake and still got him, but probably hurt his rear end. Sorry about that, Kurt.
All right, Dave Crawley Jr., double feature winner tonight. All right, now we're gonna
ready to go.
Dakota Ewing in a 25 car is leading the Pro Late Model UMP National Point Standings coming into tonight's action. All right, Matt Taylor and Robin Huffman bringing them to the green flag, and here we go! Robin Huffman and Matt Taylor side by side. Jose Parga and Jake Little. Here comes 33, Robin Huffman leading the way. Whoa! Jake Little, he was coming at us.
Had a big lead on Matt Taylor. Let's see if we can get it back.
Being chased by Matt Taylor, Jose Paga, and Dakota Ewing. But now Matt Taylor's come right up to his back bumper. Matt Taylor's on the move. Matt Taylor trying to make a run on Robin Huffman. It'll be 12 laps now. Watch out as they come around. Vic Oberlund. Whoa, Robin almost spun himself. Matt Taylor now being challenged by Jose Paga for second place. And Dakota Ewing in fourth. Six, Jose Paga trying to take that lead away from Robin Huffman. Four cars battling for the lead now. Dakota Ewing, 25, gets into it. Trying to get up to Matt Taylor. Jose Paga side by side with Robin Huffman. Jose Paga takes over the lead. Robin Huffman now back to second. Jose Paga, here comes Matt Taylor. Two laps to go, Jose Paga. Dakota Ewing moves to third. Jose Paga gets the white flag and one lap to go. Jose Paga. Jose started fourth, comes up to get the checkered flag for Jose Paga. Matt Taylor, Dakota Ewing, Robin Huffman, Eric Wilson. Wow. Boy, Robin Huffman had that thing for such a long time.
Wow.
Everybody got... Here comes Jose with a checkered flag. Good run, Matt Taylor, Dakota Ewing, and Jose. That's a checkered
Saturday
flag.
Saturday night here at Macon Speedway. Casey's General Stores Night, Armed Forces Night,
Power Eye Midgets, Micros, Pro Late Models, and the Street Stocks next Saturday night here at Macon Speedway. All right, get Jose Paga out of the race car. All right, how about a hand for Jose? Here he comes. Started fourth, just kept going. You just like Davey, you just found the opening, kept working it.
Yeah, you know, I got to thank my dad, you know, we were second guessing on setup tonight, you know, we hit it pretty good, but yeah, I mean, I love coming to this track. I had to talk my dad into it tonight, but tight racetrack, you know, everything happened so fast, I mean, It is what it is.
Keeps you on your toes and right into victory lane on a trophy. And here's Double J to get your victory photo. Jose Parga with a feature win. All right, here we go. Here's Jeremy Reed. Jeremy Reed leads the way. Jeremy Reed. One car of Tony Reed. G3 of Adam Gossett. And 911 Brad Rex Road. 35 Austin Wickline. 25 looks like he might have lost power. Slowed way down. There is Jeremy Reed. Car number 20, way off the power. Torrey Lyons comes to a stop on the front straightaway. Car number 20, Torrey Lyons with problems. In the fourth turn, six laps down. Here we go. Tony Reed was working him. He's working Jeremy. Lost a little bit of ground. Woo! There goes the wheel. Come from Cook Crawford's car? No, come from 87. Oh, it's on its way here. Catch it, Kenny.
Ready to get on the gas now with seven laps down.
Here we go. Yeah, car number 50 on the move. Ben McChristie. Tony Reed, he's giving Jeremy a workout. Oh, right alongside him. And right in front of him. So Tony Reed takes the lead from Jeremy Reed. Ooh. Jeremy's trying to fight back. Jeremy comes back on the inside. Tony Reed on the outside. Jeremy comes bouncing back to the lead. Jeremy Reed back up to the lead now. McChristie comes off the track. Mike McChristie at 50. All right. Tony Reed still working the inside on Jeremy Reed. They're going to come up. Boom, they hit. They're coming up behind Brian Offer. See if that's going to make a deal with two laps to go. Two to go. Jeremy Reed and Tony Reed. Bumper to bumper. Man, oh man. One more lap to go for Jeremy Reed and Tony Reed. Here comes a checkered flag for Jeremy Reed. Jeremy Reed sticks with it. Picks up that checkered flag. Checkered flag. All right, Jeremy Reed, he earned that one. He was getting worked big time on that. Cell Tech Solutions in Taylorville. Hoosier Dodge Daycare Boarding Center. And Jeremy Reed, boy, a Tony fellow was giving you some work, wasn't he?
Yeah, and I worked on his car all damn day so we can go racing. Ain't that some shit? I thought he was going to let me have one.
No, he was going to let you have it all right.
Yeah, this new cars, man, is giving me a bunch of gremlins left and right. I mean, we brought it out first night right off the bat, and you couldn't ask for a better night. We whooped them over at Farmer City pretty good, and that put a silver lining behind us, man. Every race since, it's one problem after another. We threw away the race in Lincoln last week, and we come out here, and I vapor locked my radiator reservoir and overheated in that big show, but thankfully we got it cooled down, and my dad and my buddy Jake, we got it put back together, and it's just, once I get this car lined out, I think it'll be a good one. But right now, she don't seem to like me too much.
It was good enough for this feature, a trophy, and Jeremy Reed is back in victory lane.